Hello everyone, this is Priyanshu Chandu, Assistant Professor of Surya Gandhi University. Today we will talk about the minerals. What is a mineral and identification of minerals? We already discussed about it. And next slide, we will discuss about dioctahedral minerals of kaolinite groups. So let's see what is it. Dioctahedral minerals of kaolinite groups in each of three minerals connected in this group, like kaolinite, dacite, and nerkelite or tetrahedral sheet is linked by its apical oxygen to an octahedral sheet connecting two thirds of its octahedral sides. Occupied by the trivalent aluminium ions. The linking oxygen to belong to both tetrahedral or octahedral sheet. Other atoms in the, this plane are the hydroxyl groups which belongs to the octahedral sheet. These hydroxyl groups are called the inner hydroxyl group and called groups and are located vertically above hexagonal activity cavity. Those hydroxyl groups cage at the outer surface of the octahedral sheet are called the outer hydroxyl group. The unit cell of kaolinite in Z, Y, or CB plane. Unit cell is that a smallest three-dimensional section of minerals. Which repeated in all the three dimension. Along the z-axis, c-dimension of the cell is started with the plane of outer hydroxyl group of the octahedral sheet having a six hydroxyl groups followed by octahedral aluminium plane, four oxygen and two hydroxyl plane, tetrahedral four silicon plane and outer six oxygen plane which makes a hydrogen bonding with the hydroxyl plane of the octahedral sheet of the next kaolinite layers unit. This distance from the hydroxyl plane of one unit to the corresponding OH plane's hydroxyl plane is the repeat distance along the C-axis and is called the C-axis spacing of the mineral. In the plane of outer oxygen, more than six oxygen are here. The oxygen with cut bond share only half with the oxygen in the unit cell. The other half is shared with the oxygen with a silicon of other unit cell. There are six such half shared oxygen and three full shared oxygen shown here in the containing a total six oxygen. If we calculate the total positive charge of the cations and the total negative charge of the anions in the unit cell, so like a cation 4 aluminium is equal 4 into 3 is totally 12 cations, and silicon 4 silicon, so 4 into 4 are 16 silicon here. And anions 6 OH is equal minus 6 into 6, so minus 6 hydroxyl, and 4 oxygen plus 2 OH minus 2 into 4 minus 1 into 2 minus 10, and 6 oxygen is equal to minus 2 into 6 is equal to minus 12. So total cations 28 and total anions minus 28. So the net charge is 0, and thus the structure is neutral. And the unit cell formula is aluminium 4, silicon 4, aluminium 4, 10 oxygen OH, confirming to the phyllosilicate formula of silicon 2 and oxygen 5 for the 1 ratio 1 trioctahedral. Serpentine, the ideal chemical composition of magnesium 6, silicon 4, oxygen 10, and hydroxide 8. Serpentine contains only divalent cations in the octahedral shape. Layer silicates minerals, the structure of 2:1 layer structure consists of central octahedral sheets joined through oxygen atoms, two tetrahedral sheets above the below. These oxygen atoms are common to octahedral sheet and tetrahedral sheet, as its apical oxygen of the tetrahedral. Pyrophyllite and the talc are the regarded as the prototype of all 2:1 minerals in dioctahedral and trioctahedral groups respectively. Pyrophyllite, this structure formula as a pyrophyllite is aluminium 4 and oxygen 8 and silicon 8 and oxygen 20 OH 4. The plane wise atomic distribution in the unit cell has been total positive and total negative charge in the unit cell due to cation and anions are equal to 44, making the structure to be ideal electroneutral. Because of its neutral structure, there are no interlayer cations, nor is there any tendency for the minerals to sell by intercations of the water or organic liquids between the layers. Pyrophyllites is relatively uncommon minerals formed by the hydrothermal alternation of feldspar, and is rarely found in the soil. It is a octahedral prototype of ideal 2:1 minerals of the same structure as that of the pyrophyllite, with the difference that is talc, all the octahedral sites are filled up by a divalent मैग्नीशियम आयंस एंड स्ट्रक्चर फॉर्मूला आर मैग्नीशियम 6 ऑक्सीजन 8 ऑक्सीजन 20 और OH4 न्यूट्रल टेलकर शो एज अ वाइडर रेंज ऑफ अ कंपोजिशन एंड मे कंटेन अ फेरस आयरन In some cases, nickel substitute for a magnesium in the octahedral sheet, but as a whole, the mineral is electroneutral, and there are neither an interlayer cation nor there is any intercalation with the organic liquid or a water sense. In talc, octahedral sheet is a bigger in B dimension because of a layer divalent ions fill up all the octahedral sheets. There is an almost exact match between a regular tetrahedral sheet and the octahedral sheet. The tetrahedral rotation is very small, is that only a 3.4 degree. There are no interlayer cations and in either a pyrophyllite or a talc, nor is there are any tendency for the minerals to swell by interaction of water and organic liquids between the layer. In both the case, the interlayer bonding is through weak van der Waal walls force to that one layer and can side over the other with the little force. These minerals materials can thus be used as a solid lubricant and due to inert nature, this find use as the filler materials. Basic skeleton of all the 2:1 minerals is either same as a pyrophyllite in case of the dioctahedral type, as talc is case of a trioctahedral type. In soil, this mineral don't confirm this ideal structure. A lot of substitution in minerals are lactic. Occur resulting in variety of minerals. Minerals arising out of this transformation among each other with respected to their like a layer change due to isomorphous substitution, location of a layer change charge and types of substituting cations. So different 2:1 minerals are different amount and location of layer charge. So mineral groups like dioctahedral minerals and layer charge equivalent unit cell range and the name of the end member minerals, octahedral substitution and tetrahedral substitution interlayer. So dioctahedral minerals like a pyrophyllite layer charge is 0 to 0.4. Octahedral substitution pyrophyllites and tetrahedral substitution pyrophyllites, no iron ore sheet. Semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi-semi octahedral and tetrahedral butadiene, any hydride cation. Vermiculites 1.2 to 1.8 vermiculites, hydrohydrate magnesium. Mica 1.8 to 0.2 Moscovita under hydride potassium. Trioctahedral minerals, talc 0.04 and talc and talcan non iron ore sheet. Semisides 0.4 to 1.2 hectorite and spironite, any hydride cation, and vermiculites 1.2 2 to 1.8 vermiculites, vermicular hydrohydrate, magnesium, and mica 1.8 to 0.8 tanonite and biotite, anhydride potassium. Mica group of minerals having a 2:1 layers structure like the pyrophyllites and the talc with a maximum layer charge due to isomorphic substitution, namely 2 equivalent per unit cell of a 4 unit in the rare britite mica. In dioctahedral mica such as the muscovita, isomorphous substitution take place in the tetrahedral sheet. 1 out of 4 silicon is a substitution via aluminium. Thus, producing 2 equivalent negative charge in the unit cell in the mica, the negatively layer charged is balanced via potassium ion in the interlayer position. Thus is the ideal unit cell formula is a K2O silicon 6 aluminium 6 oxygen 20 and OH4. Because of very high layer charge, the electrostatic energy of a 2 adjacent layer for the potassium ions in the interlayer is a very high. To reduce a very this energy, the 2 layers come close to each other, taking a potassium ions partially inside the dietrigonal cavity by scraping the water of hydrogen of potassium ion, which is weakly hydrated. This is called a potassium fixation. The unhydrated diameter of a potassium to 0.66 angstrom, which is almost same as that tetrahedral cavity. Favor this fixation process. Thus, the C-axis spacing D001 of muscovita is a 10 angstrom. An ion having a high ionic potential is at a high charge size ratio becomes strongly hydrated with a high hydration energy, which is very difficult to scrap its hydration layer. Those ions such as sodium, calcium, magnesium cannot be fixed in the interlayer of mica. Because of their high hydration energy and also due to their smaller hydration, smaller unhydrated size than the ditrigonal cavity. Muscovita is a primary mineral occurring in a different rocks. One of its weathering products is a elite which occur extensively in the soil. Its structure resembles that of muscovita, but contain less potassium. More water has less size, less than 2. And less layer of charge due to a weathering. Although mica and elytes have a very high layer charge, and a layer potassium neutralize this charge, these minerals have less cation exchange capacity. Because interlayer potassium cannot be exchanged easily with other hydride cations in solution, thus potassium is held a very tenaciously in the interlayer potassium. So vermiculites group. Dioctahedral vermiculites has a total 1.8 equivalent layer charge in the tetrahedral sheets. This charge is neutralized by a 0.9 moles of a hydride magnesium 1.8 equivalent. With the two layers of water in the interlayer position, not more than two water molecules there can be present in the interlayer because of a high electrostatic attraction due to high layer charge. Although its layer charge is more than mica, all of its layer charge is expressed as a cation exchange capacity. This interlayer magnesium can be exchanged with the other cations. Thus, this is the clay minerals having a maximum cation exchange capacity. Montmorillonite group. Montmorillonite group is a member of cementites group of minerals which with formula calcium 0.5, sodium 0.2, silicon 8, aluminium 2.8 and magnesium 1.2, oxygen 20 and hydride 4. All of these the layer of charge at 1.2 equivalent g per unit cell appears of as a cation exchange capacity and neutralized by a 0.4 moles, 1.2 equivalent calcium and 0.2 moles of sodium and exchangeable cations present in the interlayer in the hydride form. The C-axis spacing depends on moisture because of low layer charge. They can absorb a moisture in the interlayer and expand to a very high spacing, particularly with sodium. Two ratio, one ratio, one type chloride group. Structure of ditrichloride in this group. The interlayer is occupied by the trioctahedral inversite seats in this interlayer sheet, positively charged doubled by a substituting lower valent cations, say magnesium. By high valent cations, say aluminium, which then neutralize negative charge in the tetrahedral sheets or octahedral sheet thus get attached together. Thus, this mineral has a capacity this mineral has a practically no cation exchange capacity. Mixed layer minerals and enter-certified minerals. In this group, minerals are one particle's contains layer of more than one types of layer stuck together along a three-dimensional as this stucking may be a regular or random or these are called a regular or random stratified minerals respectively. Hydroxide interlayer minerals during a pedogenesis synthesis of the minerals of clay minerals and soil. Hydroxide first aluminum ions due to their positive charge enter in the interlayer of vermiculites or montmorillonite and the polymerase thereon gradually filling the interlayer position. If the interlayer is completely filled in, then a pedogenic chloride is formed. But if the interlayer is not filled completely, then the mineral found are called a hydroxyl interlayer. Vermiculites and hydroxyl interlayered montmorillonite, this mineral depicts sea access spacing of more than 10 angstrom but less than 14 angstrom. Amorphous soil constituents are those materials which lack long range order in the one or all the three dimensional produce broad or no x-rays different x-rays diffractions peaks. These materials process large specific surface area and more relatively than the crystalline minerals. They develop a variable charge on their surface. The presence of this materials markedly affect on the physical, chemical and biological properties of the soil. Paracrystalline minerals are those having a long range order, a two dimensional only with or without differ. Allophane, these are paracrystalline aluminum silicates mineral which defect produce and no x-ray diffraction effect. Allophane are very small spherical nanoparticles having a diameter 3.5 assembly made up of one aluminium octahedral and one silicon aluminum tetrahedral sheet silicon aluminum ratio is more than one. Amoglobulinate, these are a paracrystalline amino silicates minerals without a defect, produce a broad X-rays difference peak. Amoglobulinate are in the form of a very thin 100,000 nm along tubes having a diameter of about 2 nm made up of the one gibbsite sheet covered in the form of the tube. The orthosilicates group attached to the inside of the tube silica aluminum ratio is 1. Aluminum and emogolite occurs the pathogenic due to a soil process. Product not only in the endosol salts derived from the volcanic ash, but also is those derived from the massive basalt. Opaline silicates, these are non crystalline circular or the epical plates or a sphere of 100 to 1000 nm size. These are three dimensional tectosilicates with only a short range order. Ferrihydrite, it consists of a spherical with a diameter of 3 to 10 nm and has a hematite like structure where oxygen is replaced by a hydrogen group. So oxides and hydroxide, oxygen oxides and hydroxides of aluminium and iron occur dominantly in soil. Independent crystalline minerals are as amorphous coating on other minerals such as rare silicates. When these minerals are formed as a fresh precipitates, these are amorphous with a small particle and large specific surface, are more solubility and reactivity as exhibited by the adsorption of other ions and molecules on their surface. The common feature of these minerals that a cation, aluminium, iron, and manganese remain in octahedral coordination of a six-fold coordination surrounded by a six group as at the six corner of and the imaginary regular octahedron with oxygen, hydroxide, and water, or a several combination of these groups. Some of these compounds having the same chemical formula, but these different types of packing, such as a cubic close packing of hexagonal close packing, she earlier section lead to the different types of symmetry and crystal system. These types of minerals having a same chemical formula, different structure of packing or three dimensional are called a polymorphous, and this phenomena is called polymorphism. Aluminium hydroxides and oxyhydroxides, aluminium hydroxide, aluminium the gibbsite is most commonly found in soil. And the other two uncommon polymorphs are the barite and norstenite. एल्यूमिनियम ऑक्सी हाइड्रोक्साइड बियोथाइमाइन एंड डाई स्पोर्स और टू पॉलीमॉर्फस हैव माइनर अकरनेस इन द सॉइल देन गिब्साइड. एल्यूमिनियम ऑक्साइड the anhydrous aluminium oxide a high temperature product is present only a minor components of igneous and metamorphic rocks. So he have completed all about dioctahedral minerals of kaolinite groups, layers of silicate minerals, and all these are principle of structure group and mica groups, different 2:1 minerals and different amount and location of layer charge, and vermiculites groups and montmorillonite groups and types of chloride groups and mixed layer minerals and intersatisfied minerals. Hydroxy interlayer minerals and amorphous soil constituents oxides and hydroxides oxides and aluminium hydroxides and oxy hydroxides groups. Thank you.